Hello friends, today I am going to explain about how to file ITR-1 return in case of salaried employees. So first visit here income tax india efiling.gov.in, and once you visit you will get this screen here. If you want link your Aadhaar, you can link here, so with your PAN, and here you just click on this ITRs, just click on ITRs. You will get options like this: ITR-1, ITR-2, ITR-3, ITR-4, ITR-4, ITR-5, ITR-6. So here you have to select assessment area, okay? So and accordingly you can download here Excel utility file here, download. In case of salaries, we'll use ITR-1. So today I'll explain about how to file ITR-1. So just you download here, okay? Click on here download. It will download, and after that, see here. This is utility file ITR-1 utility file. See here ITR-1 utility file. You have to fill all the details: income details, TDS, TCS in case of TCS, tax paid, and in case any ATG. Okay, so I'll show you how to fill and what are the mandatory details, and I'll show you. This is the empty Excel file here. Okay, empty Excel file here. See here, first your name, first name, middle name, surname, and your PAN number, and your Aadhaar number here, and your address. Okay, total complete your address here. So and flat number and all, and date of birth, and your area and city and state and country, and with PIN code. Okay, next. So after, see here, after filling of all the details in income details sheet, you have to click on validate. So in case any error, it will show you. Okay, you just click on validate. So after filling all the details in sheet, okay, next, here your email address, mobile number, and other. Okay, here other means I'll show you here. So employer category, so like government, so you will get like these options. You have to select others in case of private organizations. Okay, you have to select others. Okay, and return filed on or before date. If you file before due date means 31st July, so you can select 11. Okay, on or before due date. So after due date means after 31st July, you can select 12. Okay, and here original. So whether original or revised return, so we are filing original return, right? You just select original. So here you will get two options: one is original and revised. So in case revised, you can just select revised. Okay, and here you have to select resident status. Okay, you will get options here, resident status. Okay, so accordingly you can select it. Okay, see here original and revised, and if you come down here you will get options: resident, NRA, like that. So accordingly you can select. And income from salary, this is your income from salary. Okay, I'll show you one more file. See here, this is your gross salary, total gross salary. Okay, and after that, exempt under section 10, there is HRA, conveyance, and medical. So earlier conveyance it was 800 into 12 months. Now it was changed 1600 into 12, that is 19,200. So yearly. So after exempt under section 10, professional tax, here tax and employment, this is monthly 200, and 12 months 2400. So after these three and 2400, this is your income from salary, gross total income. Okay, 3,56,040. So just I'm showing you example. Okay, after this exemptions and this professional tax and employment, you have to put the value here. Okay, here you have to put value. Okay, and here, so in case of ATC, it will allow only up to 1,50,000. It will take exemption. So accordingly you can fill here. In case of ATD, you have to select options here, self and family, or self and family including parents. So like this you have to select, and you have to put here amount, okay, and it will take accordingly. So as per the sections, okay, as per the directions, so section wise we can put, so based on your savings, okay. This is total gross total income after HRA and conveyance and medical and professional tax, tax and employment. This is your 5,32,000 is 302 is the gross total income, and this is the deduction is 1,23,000 under ATC, and taxable total income. So if you less 5,32,302 rupees minus 1,23,000, you will get this, okay, 4 lakhs. On that, okay, minus 2.5 lakhs income tax exemption, and remaining value it will calculate 5%. As per the new slab rates, it will applicable 5% here, okay. You just check this slab rates, new slab rates, and rebate. This is the total tax payable amount, 15,930 rupees minus rebate, okay, and this is the tax payable after rebate, okay. See here, CIS, including CIS, 11,258 have to pay, okay. And details of tax deducted at sources from salary. So as per your form 16, see, I worked two companies in last financial year. See your company TAN number and your company name. So like I worked Accenture, so you just mention Accenture. You worked for Wipro, you worked for some other company, you just put here your company name and income chargeable. So as per your form 16 part B, you just mention here. So you'll get all the details in your form 16 part B, okay, and how much they deducted that you put here. So like that it will calculate automatically tax here, and just after filling the sheet, see here, after filling your sheet, you just click on validate. After filling all the details, see, you just click on validate, okay. Is there any errors, it will show, okay. And in case of other than salary, you just fill the details, okay. Form 16A for other than salary, form 16 for salaries, okay. You just TAN number and all you have to fill here, name of the deductor, and which tax subject to deduction, and deduction year, tax deducted, so amount, so everything you have to fill. In case of advanced tax and self-assessment, is there any tax payable, so you have to pay self-assessment tax, the same thing you have to fill all the details here. Say example, what is the BSR code, okay. So once you pay self-assessment tax, so you'll get chalana, in that you'll get all these details, BSR code, date of deposit, serial number and tax paid, everything will get here, okay. So accordingly you can fill it, okay. In case of TCS, you just fill here tax collected at sources, otherwise you just click on validate and go to next page, okay. See here, total 11,000 change I have to pay, okay. So I claimed 8,811 rupees, the remaining how much I have to pay, 2,450. Here see, amount payable. In case of refund, if they have deducted more, means so I'll get refund, so it will show here under refund, okay. And here, so in case of refund, you just fill your bank details here, IFSC code and name of bank and account number, and here verification, here it will come your name automatically, and your father name will come automatically, and just write your place Hyderabad, and PAN number will come automatically, and date of e-filing you just put here, okay. And even if you have other bank accounts also, you have to details of bank held outside India, or so other bank details also you have to fill, okay. So ATG, this is the donation related, so if you have any donations, you just fill here. So my case, there is no donations, and you just click on validate. So after completion of sheet, you just click on validate, okay. and so visit this site incometaxindiafiling.gov.in. So before this I'll tell you. Okay, so after see here, after filling all these sheets, TDS, TCS and tax paid and verification, ATG, okay, you just click on here income details, you just click on calculate tax. So is there any errors, you just accordingly can fill, and so if everything fine means you can generate XML file. You just click on generate XML file, so it will generate, the file will be like this. Okay, it will generate like this ITR1, see, like this it will generate. So this file we have to upload. Okay, this file we have to upload, see, XML document. Okay, and this file we have to upload, so that I'll show you. So you just log in here, so visit this incometaxindiafiling.gov.in. You just click on login, so your user ID, password, and enter captcha here, and you just click on login. So after login, you just go to e-file, upload return. So here you have to select that XML file here, okay, and select, and you have to select assessment here, and you have to submit it. Okay, you have to submit. Okay, after submission you can view your return here. See, go to my account and view e-file returns or forms. If you want to see form 226 yes also, you can see. So in that particular financial year, so you can able to see your salary details and tax details also, you can able to see here in form 226 yes, and view your file returns. Okay, if you click on this view e-file return forms, you will get this screen. Okay, if you click on this, you will get this screen. See, filing date, original or revised, you can original, acknowledgement number, successfully verified. Now you need not to send this acknowledgement to Bangalore office, Bangalore IT office, because see, once you will log in, so while filling this ITR, so you have to mention some your bank details. Okay, the same bank account, you just log in your net banking, and there you will get option like income tax or some direct taxes. So you just click on that, it will show you procedure you can follow, and it will redirect to again incometaxindiafiling.gov.in, and you will get one message like your return successfully e-verified. Okay, you can able to see here successfully e-verified. Before this it will show e-verify, just e-verify. So after completion of e-verification, it will show successfully e-verified. Okay, like that you can file ITR. Everyone can file ITR easy. Okay, so by uploading, if you use Excel utility file, you can upload here return XML file. Otherwise, if you click on prepare and submit online ITR, you can directly click and you just mention, you can directly fill it and you can directly submit it. You need not to again upload ITR Excel utility file here. Okay, you'll get options here, like what is your total income, salary, what are the deductions, and your name, bank details, all you can fill it here. Okay, I hope this information will help you. I think 31st 7 2017 is the due date. Okay, thanks for watching my videos. Thank you.